We have studied a lot about magnets and the different kinds of magnets that we have, and they aid us in our daily lives. So let us say that you are curious as to how a magnet influences other substances. Because in my previous lectures, I have told you a lot about how one magnet is able to influence another magnet or another substance. So let us say, you being curious, you bought yourself a magnet and you are taking it near different substances at your home to find out how it influences that particular substance. So when you bring this particular magnet in front of nails or coins, you will find that these substances are strongly attracted by the magnet. Now, coins are usually made of an alloy of nickel, and these nails are usually made of iron. So these substances you find will be strongly attracted by the magnet. On the contrary, if you take this magnet near any aluminium utensil or aluminium foils, like the ones you see in the picture, you will find that these are attracted, but feebly attracted by the magnet, not as strongly as the coins or the nails were attracted. Now let's say you take this magnet near some other substances. For example, your mother's jewelry. Now jewelry is usually made of gold, and a bigger surprise awaits you when you will find that gold is feebly repelled by the magnet, not strongly or feebly attracted, but feebly repelled. A similar result you will find if you take this magnet near any copper item. Let's say copper utensils. Even they will be feebly repelled by the magnet. So we found that there are three kinds of behavior that a substance can exhibit when brought near a magnet. So based on this behavior, substances can be classified into three broad categories. We found that iron, which were the nails, and nickel, which is contained in coins, are strongly attracted by magnets. So the substances which are strongly attracted by a magnet are known as ferromagnetic substances, or simply magnetic substances. Since ferromagnetic substances are strongly attracted, generally they are known as magnetic substances. We found that aluminium was feebly attracted by a magnet. And same is the case with zinc. Even zinc is feebly attracted by a magnet. So such substances which are very feebly attracted by a strong magnet are known as paramagnetic substances. The force of attraction in between the magnet and these substances is very, very feeble. On the other hand, we found yet some other substances which are neither attracted feebly nor strongly. They are simply repelled by the magnet. So the substances which are feebly repelled by either pole of a magnet, be it south or north, these are known as diamagnetic substances. So when I talk about diamagnetic substances, it means that these substances are not attracted but repelled. And we saw some examples of diamagnetic substances, gold and copper. So based on the behavior with which they interact with the magnet, a substance can be classified in three categories. That is, various substances can be classified under these three categories: ferromagnetic or simply magnetic substances, paramagnetic substances, and diamagnetic substances.